Hello and welcome to Pioneer TV. I'm your host, Dondre Lemon.
And I'm your host, Chiara Genti.
Bikes have made an appearance on campus. On Friday, October 13th, 25 new yellow bikes were stationed all over campus. The bikes will be available to all students and can be found in front of the library, Post Hall, and Nassau and Suffolk Hall. Students will be required to enter a code to unlock the bikes. The code and more information on the Pioneer bikes can be found on www.liupostpioneer.com.
WCWP, LIU Post Radio Station, held their annual scavenger hunt on October 23rd through 26th. This year, 44 students participated on 22 teams for a wonderful $100 Visa gift card. This year, the radio station used Snapchat to create an artistic and fair way to monitor the teams.
Coming up, if you are a commuter student, you will notice the freshly repaved roads and speed bumps. However, are the speed bumps on campus having cars take flight?
Been sitting eyes wide open behind these four walls, hoping you come. Existence like it's no point hoping at all. Baby, baby, I feel crazy. Up all night, and every day. Give me something, but you say nothing. What is happening in
the... Hey, I'm Nick. Let's get right into it. And what is happening on Long Island? Ted Sperling presents George and Ira Gershwin's Of Thee I Sing. Full of a hit-filled score, this semi-stage concert version of one of George and Ira Gershwin's finest creations will feature Broadway performers and is a hilarious and timeless all-American political satire that is as relevant as ever. The show is November 4th at 8 p.m. and tickets are available at the box office and online at tillacenter.org. Blue Oyster Cult and Jefferson Starship take over LIU's Tilla Center. With Bourbon Stills Band opening the show, you're bound to have a great time. The show is November 10th at 7:30 p.m. and tickets are available at the box office and online at tillacenter.org. Get them before they sell out. And finally, the Move-a-thon. Get ready to move for a cause. LIU Brookville is hosting its official Move-a-thon this November 16th. All funds going to Don Monte Foundation for Pediatric Cancer Research. This event is a 10-hour, no-sitting, no-seating, consistent moving marathon on campus, so make sure to get involved. For more information on this event and any other on-campus event, head to news.liu.edu. I'm Nick Tangora, and I'll see you next time.
The roads and speed bumps on Post Lane were repaved over the summer of 2017. However, due to the dark, unmarked bumps, students and faculty can find themselves taking a short flight while hurrying to their next class. The speed bump signs are required to be 75 to 95 feet away from the bump. However, this still causes a surprise to many drivers.
Midnight Madness was a success for the students of LIU Post. Midnight Madness took place on October 26th at the Pratt Center. Many students came to show pride and enjoy a little basketball fun. And for more on this story, go to www.postpioneer.com. The women's volleyball team has been on a hot streak, winning 12 games straight. Since the beginning of the season, the team's record was 21-3 before falling to their arch rival, Molloy College. Their next match will be on November 4th at Roberts Wesleyan College.
Along with the women's volleyball team, the women and men's soccer team had a win against Mercy College, leaving no mercy, giving them a day of zeros. Also, the women's tennis team had a close game against RWC with a final score of 5-4.
That's all the time that we have for you today. I'm your host, Chiara Genti.
And I'm Dondre Lemon. Make sure to pick up The Pioneer every Wednesday and check us out on the web at www.liupostpioneer.com. And we'll see you next time.
See you next time.